Alright, hey everybody, I'm Brocoum. I'm the lead developer at a company called Syncta. It's kind of a new company here in Beaverton, down the street. And if you're on the PDX Ruby Brigade Google group, I'm the one who sent the job posting last week, looking for Ruby on Rails. So I figured I'd come here to the PDX Ruby Brigade, find you guys and tell you all about it. And you can either come talk to me if you're looking for a job or pass it on to your friends. We're looking for a mid-level Ruby on Rails developer, if you want to see experience and stuff. Someone who's ready to move up to a sort of senior position. Let's see. Let's go to the next tab, and I'll show you what I do. So our company is Syncta, and our tagline is backflow simple. Now, most people might not know what backflow is, and it's what keeps our drinking water clean at. So, the example is, suppose you have a sprinkler system in your water, and you're fertilizing it with your water. And you don't want the fertilizer to go backwards through the pipe and come out of your sink and you end up drinking fertilizer. So, every potable drinking water in the country will have a backflow device attached to it. And that prevents water from going the wrong way. And what Syncta does is, you know, testers test these things, but all these devices have. And we make software for them. In the old days, you lose water on the clipboard, test the device, break down the tests, mail it off to the water player a couple weeks later to get it, send it back to you. And now you can do it on your phone. And that's what we're doing here. Founder grew up in Beaverton, that's why we're headquartered here. And we were just acquired by a company called Watts Water. So go to the next tab. You see, Watts is actually a $1 billion company, just bought a small company. So we're a small company, about 10 people in Portland. Just acquired by very large companies and resources, and now we're stacking up. And that's why I'm here. So actually, let's go to the next tab. This is what a backflow device looks like. Just pulling you guys in a little back in the background here. It's a device kind of, you know, this big or so, but come out size to it. Residential one kind of this big. And this is a double check, and you can see down here, double check power assembly is designed to prevent the backflow of polluted water from entering the potable water supply. And so, this is the sort of thing that our test program tests. This is what our software tests to make sure it's working properly. Now, you're not expecting to know any of this, you're expecting to know Ruby. That's what I'm here for. The domain that we have is very, very specific. I didn't know anything about backflow before I started. The founder's father was a backflow tester, that's how he got into it. And believe it or not, there's about 50,000 backflow testers in the US. And they're the ones who use our software. And a lot of them too, a lot of them. So let's go to the next tab. I'll show you the actual app that we have. Just as a little glance into it. This is Syncta. This is what the testers see when they log in. This is what I'm working on. This is what we're looking for someone else to help us work on. Every backflow testing company has customers. They have tests that they do, they have routes. So for example, if you're a backflow tester, you want to test 20 devices a day. You go into Google tells you the most efficient route to get around the day. We do all that in our software. And most of the time, you go to the next tab. People are using the software on their phones, of course. So this is what it would look like in an iPhone 6, 7, 8 here. We have a responsive site. And this is what a backflow test looks like. Check one, check two, three, everything is done. You can scroll down a bit more. And that's what a dense sprinkler system is. It's a fairly simple CRUD piece of software, like create, read, update, delete. It's important in that drinking water is important, but it's not flash on in the way that it's self-driving cars are flashing, or space access flashing, you have to have space, and that creates machine learning for artificial intelligence. We're just helping make the world a slightly better place than they can drink more cleaner. And that's how we're going to go. Let's move on to the next. So this is the posting I put up last week. Some of you might have read it. And go to the next tab. It's actually for a hybrid remote company. So I live here in Portland, like many of you, and then headquartered in Beaverton, about 10 of us, as I mentioned. So I often work from home, come to God. comes once or twice a week. And we have developed a world of about this. We're all remote. One of them is in California, one of them is here in Northern Asia. And again, we're looking for, say, a mid-level developer to come on who wants to take on a bigger challenge, ready to start working with a pretty big code base when it already exists. We're, of course, here in Portland, great, but we're also remote, so if you know any friends or viewers anywhere in the world, let us know. And that's my little spiel. I just want to tell you what I'm doing. I'm looking for a Ruby on Rails developer. Here I am, Ruby for data. Probably the right place. What backflow is, even though I explained it, that's not your problem. What is backflow? Yeah, I'm talking about the hardware. Oh, sure. No, let's go back to that. The Home Depot. Not the plumbing, but no. How it actually works. So, what is the software testing? So this is called a double check device, and I guess we'll flip back and forth. So, double check device. There's two valves. These green levers turn the water on and off. So the water will flow in from one direction and out the other direction and turn it off. And when it does that, so there's a bunch of types of backflow devices. This one is the simplest one. It's called double check. And when the tester comes by, they have this big kit. It looks like it's like a PSI. It looks like a scale, right? It's this big circle, has a scale that goes like this, and measures the PSI. So the pounds per square inch of the water pressure inside each of the checks. And if you go to the app, the one that's on the phone, yeah, you can see here, check one, check two, type leaked. So when you're doing a backflow test, it takes about, it takes like 30 seconds. You go in, you take the hose on, measure the pressure. If the pressure is one or less, that's less than what I asked for pressure when it's leaking. Because presumably, like the line pressure you can see there, the water is going to be high pressure, 5, 10, whatever, 20. So you don't want it to be less than one PSI, that means it's leaking. And you would mark that as leaked, both the checks have to pass, and if it fails, you often have to fix it. So you would take the backflow device apart, often it's just blown, shake it out, just dump it, put that together again, you check it again, if it works now, that's fixed, and then you charge the water away. And you say, hey, $25 or whatever I tested your device. And so our software makes it much better, right? You imagine the difference. You do a test, you can't say, you fill out the paper, you send it off the mail, you pay a month later, you pay and remember to pay the call. Now, with our software, you do the test, you get paid the next day or whatever, you send an email. So that's a real bit for testers, the efficiency there. Yeah, I'm so passionate about that. I mean, I'm really bad passionate about it. Side of it, I'm sure you are, but yeah, important stuff.